I'm Dr. Victor Dolan, and I know that your most precious asset is your good health. I also know the best way to attain and maintain that good health is naturally, through diet, lifestyle, exercise, education, and information. And that's what this show is all about, good health naturally. Today, I'm very honored to have as a guest Dr. Victor Dolan. It's a pleasure to have him here. It's a pleasure to bring him to your living rooms, a pleasure to bring him to your television set. Today we're going to discuss a natural approach to health, chiropractic. Dr. Victor Dolan has done well over 300 television shows here at Staten Island's CTV. I'm sure many of you have seen his face and are very familiar with his face. Dr. Dolan, it's a pleasure to have you here. And first off, I'd like to ask you, you call yourself the natural health doctor. Why do you call yourself the natural health doctor?
Well, first of all, Dr. Dolan, thank you for having me here on the show. It's a marvelous opportunity to talk to your viewers and talk to my viewers who also watch my show about chiropractic as an alternative and natural approach to health. As you've stated, I've done over 300 half-hour TV shows, the vast majority having to do with natural approaches to health or alternative approaches to health. I call myself the natural health doctor, and my patients and public call myself the natural health doctor because chiropractic is a natural approach to health, a drugless, no surgical intervention,
Do you think that chiropractic is the only natural health approach, or when you say you're into alternative health care or natural health care, is natural health care synonymous with chiropractic? Is chiropractic synonymous with natural health care? Is natural health care synonymous with alternative health care?
Well, I think chiropractic is synonymous with natural health care. I don't know that it's any longer synonymous with alternative health care. It has become quite mainstream. For some people, chiropractic is still fringe or alternative, but it's becoming more and more accepted all the time. But chiropractic is natural because it doesn't use any chemicals or anything outside the body. It helps the body heal itself. And by so doing, by definition, it's a natural approach to health. However, alternative, I don't know that I would still consider it the only alternative approach to health or even an alternative approach to health. There are other approaches that are much more out of the mainstream, much more out of the...
That's very good, thank you. What is chiropractic? Can you define chiropractic for us? Tell us as to the derivation of the term. It's an odd word. People don't know whether to call it chiropractic, chiropractry, chiropractic medicine. What is the derivation of chiropractic? What does it mean? What does it entail?
Well, if you use a term like chiropractic medicine, it is appropriate if you're using medicine in the generic term, medicine just meaning healthcare. But medicine is also a proper name to a specific approach to health. Chiropractic medicine is okay if it's a generic term. Chiropractic is a Greek term, a couple of Greek words put together back over 100 years ago. Chiro meaning hands and practic meaning to do by. So actually it's to practice by hands. A big part of the chiropractic practice is to palpate by hands and investigate a person's spine and then correct a problem that you find in that spine with your hands. I like to use my hands for what they call osseous adjustments. Mm-hmm. Chiropractic mm-hmm. works on the nervous system by adjusting the bones or manipulating the bones in the spine as well as the other joints in the body to remove nerve interference. Chiropractic is the removal of nerve interference, primarily.
Well, you've been out here beating the drum for a long time about natural health care, about chiropractic health care. How do you think that the public has received your message? How has the public received alternative health care, natural health care? What has been the public's reaction to the outgrowth of chiropractic? We know it's been around for 100 years. Thanks to your exposition. What has it done in the last few years? Is it growing? Has it plateaued? What do you see as the future for chiropractic?
Well, Chiropractic is booming. Natural approaches of health are booming. Alternative health care is booming. Way back in the 1970s, when I was coming of age, people got into jogging, people got into vitamins, people became aware of other avenues to health. That's not saying that there's anything particularly right or wrong with American medicine, but medicine is one approach to health. There are many different avenues to health. Chiropractic is growing. More and more people are coming under chiropractic care. They understand that chiropractic is good for backaches, neck aches, headaches, but also by working on the spine, by working on the nervous system, by restoring homeostasis, by keeping things in proper alignment, it helps your whole health. All sorts of health complaints, from organic dysfunctions, all kinds of complaints can be treated either solely through chiropractic or concurrently with other methods. Nowadays, concurrent treatment is very common. Someone may have a severe problem where they're under medical care, yet they're also visiting the doctor of chiropractic for a natural approach to health to help their body heal itself from above down, inside out, which is the way chiropractic comes.
Still, chiropractic is a strange term and a strange philosophy, strange science for many people. What is the hypothesis? What is the scientific foundation for chiropractic? What is the philosophy, art, and science of chiropractic? What is it based upon?
Well, chiropractic is based upon the fact that all the health professions study, all the health professions agree upon, that the nervous system controls and coordinates all activities in the human body. Gray's Anatomy, one of the Bibles of healthcare, whether you're a medical doctor, a nurse, a podiatrist, a dentist, a chiropractor, states the nervous system controls and coordinates all activities with the human body. Chiropractic works on that nervous system. When you have a subluxation, a misalignment, a kink, a problem in the spine, it may or may not cause pain, but that kink, that subluxation, that misalignment, that fixation, that lack of proper motion will interfere with the way the nervous system functions. When the nervous system doesn't function right, you don't function right. When your nervous system functions at the best level it can, you are healthier by definition, by Gray's Anatomy. When your nervous system functions properly, you function properly. So chiropractic can attack specific problems, but it also helps build health. Again, it's a natural approach to health. It doesn't have to zero in on a problem, although it can, but it helps your body heal itself from the inside out by removing interference to the nervous system, by removing the subluxation, the kink, the misalignment, primarily by an adjustment. The term may be more general and called a manipulation. The chiropractors like the term adjustment because it's specific to a problem area.
Well, you use some terms that I am familiar with, of course, but with which our viewing audience may not be familiar with. You have to define some of these terms. Let's just start off with the basis of chiropractic, the term subluxation. Can you explain in a scientific way as well as a layman's way, so that everyone can understand it, what exactly is a subluxation? How does it affect our health? What is it? What does it do?
Well, a subluxation is the problem treated by chiropractic. A chiropractor may use x-rays, EMGs, NCVs, MRIs, CAT scans, thermography, Moray contography, different things to locate and pinpoint problems along the spine, or primarily the spinal column, where a joint fixation occurs, where a bone is out of alignment, displaced or misplaced. It's almost microscopic in the amount that it's out. But trained hands, trained eyes, a trained chiropractor can locate a subluxation which interferes with the proper functioning of the nervous system. It irritates the nervous system. And again, when that nervous system doesn't function right, you don't function right. By definition, you cannot be healthy if you have a subluxation. Yet subluxation doesn't have to cause a symptom or a disease or even pain. Some people can be full of subluxations in plural or have a major subluxation, yet be totally unaware of it. They don't know that they're unhealthy because it has...
So this subluxation, this misalignment, this kink, which affects so many parts of our body, which is so far-reaching, and you say sometimes it may not even cause any pain.
Right. It may not cause any pain. You could have a cavity growing in your tooth right now. You don't feel it until it hits a nerve. You could have high blood pressure right now and be unaware of it. You could have plaque growing in your coronary arteries, and you don't know you have a problem until you get pain, until
you
get a heart attack.
Subluxated and not in particular have any pain as the symptom, but could have various other symptoms that show your nervous system is not functioning properly.
Well, yes. The patient may not have any severe symptoms, may not have any...
Could you be symptom-free? Could you be disease-free and have subluxations?
Yes, you could be disease-free because disease is a clinical entity. You could be subclinical. You could be in the preparatory stages for having a disease and having symptoms and having pain. Pain only comes about from damaged tissue. And you could be building damage over time and still be pain-free, but have a subluxation. And that subluxation doesn't cause a problem, quote, until it causes you pain. However, it is deleterious to your health. It is causing you a problem, even though you're not aware of it. Just like that high blood pressure could be, or just like in my tooth, a hole growing in my tooth.
Now, some people use chiropractors to maintain their health, or many people say that chiropractic is a preventative approach to disease, a health maintenance type of approach.
Yes.
What exactly is meant by this preventative or health maintenance type of approach? Can you explain chiropractic's viewpoint on health maintenance and the prevention of disease? How does chiropractic work in that manner?
Well, chiropractic can treat your body the way you bring your car to the neighborhood mechanic for an oil change or a tune-up. When your nervous system functions properly, you function better. When we remove stress from the body, stress is a big thing nowadays. A subluxation creates stress in your nervous system. Nervous system can't function right. Your organs can't function right. You don't have the proper coordination. You don't have the proper strength. You don't have the proper sensation or feelings. So people have gotten the idea that you don't have to wait for a problem to develop by keeping your spine in line, not to sound trite, but you can keep problems away by keeping everything well-oiled and well-maintained and tuned up and new oil and a new oil filter. The car runs
now better. You've used several terms. We've started off with chiropractic. We've used the term subluxation, and we've used the term adjustment. Could you please explain to everybody exactly what is an adjustment? Is that synonymous with manipulation? Is that synonymous with mobilization? What is the difference between an adjustment and various other terms used when you manipulate a joint or a body part?
Well, laymen or other professions outside of chiropractic like to use terms like manipulation or mobilization. Chiropractors prefer to use the term adjustment. An adjustment is a specific manipulation. An adjustment is a specific mobilization of the joint that is not functioning properly. When I would manipulate someone or mobilize someone, I may mobilize their whole spine. But when I adjust, I want to put my hands on someone, and right underneath my hands, I want to feel a movement. I want to feel the joints get freed from their restriction. I want to feel a bone move out of its subluxated spot back into proper alignment, where its movement will be more free, where it returns the spinal bones to proper position, which relieves interference from the spinal nerves.
Okay. Another term that you seem to be using quite freely is the term innate or instinctual. What does innate mean? What does this have to do with homeostasis? Explain those terms to me. What exactly is innate? What does that have to do with me?
Well, innate is a term that was popularized by early chiropractors, particularly D.D. Palmer and B.J. Palmer, and is almost philosophical, meaning that the body can correct and repair itself from the inside out. Health comes from inside you out. Your body repairs itself. Homeostasis is a scientific term, I guess a biological term more so than a chemical term. The biology of a living organism to maintain itself in relation to its environment. For instance, take in enough water, let out water at a certain rate, to take in food or nutrients. The body scientifically maintains homeostasis, and that's done through an innate instinctual mechanism. You don't think about digestion of food, but homeostasis takes place because of your innate instinctual inborn God-given or nature-given ability to maintain that homeostasis. But homeostasis and innate are pretty much interchangeable, homeostasis being more scientific and innate being more philosophical, and innate being pretty much a chiropractic type term.
Okay. Now, where do you see natural health care going? Where do you see chiropractic health care going in the future? We are winding down the decade, we're winding down the century, we're actually winding down a millennia. As we enter the new millennium, will there be a greater importance, a greater usage of natural health care? Do you think chiropractic will continue to be the premier form of natural health care in the United States? What do you see taking place over the next decade, the next century, the next millennium? Do you see chiropractic being more greatly utilized or less utilized? What's the future for chiropractic?
Well, I wish I could see forward into the next millennium, even into the next decade, because then I'd know what stocks to buy. But I see chiropractic growing, and I do think chiropractic is the preeminent natural approach to health. As I said, alternative, well, now it's pretty much mainstream, so it's losing its alternative name tag. But chiropractors have a survey of knowledge in an expertise in chiropractic, but a survey of knowledge in nutrition, in aromatherapy, in biofeedback, in magnetic therapy. Because of our eclectic interests, I do think chiropractic will continue to be on the forefront of natural health care. And also, since we're licensed in all 50 states, people will come to us because we bridge the gap between traditional orthodox medical health care, which is licensed everywhere in the world, and the fringe or new age or different or alternative health care. Chiropractic is a bridge between that. Scientifically sound, safe, efficient, and cost efficient, yet with greater acceptance within the orthodox medical community, orthodox health care. So I see greater usage for chiropractic, greater acceptance, more and more patients coming under our care.
Everything can't be rosy. Everything can't be all optimism. What problems lay ahead? What are your greatest fears about the profession of chiropractic? What are the greatest problems that natural health care faces in the future, or alternative health care? What problems, what fears do you have for the upcoming time in chiropractic?
Well, chiropractic's been satisfying patients for well over 100 years now. So I hate to be a rosy optimist. I don't see great problems for chiropractic with patient acceptance or scientific acceptance. I see big problems for healthcare in general currently, because the pendulum has swung towards managed healthcare, which limits patient access to necessary treatment, whether it's medical or alternative or natural. I see problems in healthcare in literally the economic survival of the practitioners and facilities. but patient acceptance, scientific acceptance is growing. I hate to sound like a cockeyed optimist, but chiropractic is going to survive. Natural healthcare is going to survive despite a hostile marketplace fostered by managed care, which does not leave patients satisfied. And chiropractors are out there at the forefront, fighting against managed care and with managed care to give greater services to our patients. And patients report great satisfaction with chiropractic in every survey that's done. So I guess mainly the problems I see ahead are economic tough times, but only for the next few years.
You've raised a lot of important points about health and disease and health maintenance and longevity. I'm sure a lot of our viewing audience would like to know how to get in touch with you. They could give you a call and ask some questions or get some further information on the topics that we've covered on this program. How could I get in touch with you? Where could we get in touch with you if we wanted to give a call?
Well, I'm listed in the Yellow Pages. You can give me a call at my office, 981-9755. I'll easily come to the phone and help you out if I can over the phone. Or otherwise, you can contact me here through CTV, 727-1414. CTV 100 Cable Way, Staten Island, New York, 10303. And
in your office, what kind of patients do you see? What are the most common problems? What kind of symptoms or difficulties come into your office? And do you actually have a lot of people that are interested in the prevention of problems and the realization of their full health potential and the realization of health maintenance? What's your youngest patient? What's your oldest patient? Ratio of men to women, types of problems. Tell me a little bit about your practice profile. Who walks into your office?
Well, thanks to shows like this, thanks to viewers out there that have seen my show, your show, our shows together, who are aware of or alternative health care, natural health care, a lot of people come to my office just for health maintenance. But I see kids and adults. I have patients as young as several days old up to several decades old. I have patients in their 90s, just a couple of those. I have quite a few in their 80s, many more in their 70s. It's 50-50, women and men. A lot of athletes, because they're interested in maintaining or reaching their fullest potential. Biggest complaint across the country is low back pain. After that comes headaches and neck aches. Some of my practice is what you call acute care, people bent up in pain, hurting in pain. But also I have some chronic care. People come in once a month or a couple times a month or once a quarter, a couple times a year. To get their spines tuned up, just like they take care of your car or something like that. Health maintenance is a big thing. Realization of full potential is getting into people's heads.
Well, I have to say that your outlook, your experiences, your practice very much mirrors mine, where, as a matter of fact, I'd have to say that we are almost identical in our outlook and in the way we practice. Tell me, what made you interested in chiropractic? A lot of times I like to touch a little bit on the personal history of people. What got you interested in chiropractic? Why did you become a chiropractor?
Well, first of all, thank you for saying that we're similar. I admire and respect you quite a lot, Dr. Dolan, and it's my pleasure and honor to be associated with people like you. And I'm glad that our practices mirror each other's. As to what made me interested in chiropractic, I came of age in the 1970s. There was a questioning of authority. Traditional authoritarian establishments were under fire questioning. Watergate, vitamins came in, running and jogging came in. So I became interested in natural and alternative approaches to health. I was always interested in biology and chemistry in high school and in college. So when it came time to go on from college, or what I prepared for in college, was to go on to a graduate school. And the graduate school that appealed to me was chiropractic, with a safe, natural approach to health, something since I was a product of the times. It appealed to me coming mm-hmm. from that era, coming mm-hmm. from that time. I'm happy that I'm in it. It's a great profession. It's a very satisfying profession to help someone with your own two hands, as you are well aware. It's very satisfying to see the progress we've made. We're becoming more and more accepted. As you're well aware, we're becoming accepted even into hospitals here on Staten Island, which is a great thing.
We're getting the sign to wrap it up. So how would you like to finish to talk to Staten Island as we wrap it up? Please face the camera and say something to our Staten Island audience.
Well, Staten Island, I'm glad you've watched the show. I hope you found it entertaining and informative. Dr. Dolan does a great job.
Thank you very much.
I hope you've watched my show as well.
On Good Health Naturally, Dr. Victor E. Dolan, Staten Island native, Staten Island born and raised, a practitioner of chiropractic here on Staten Island. I'd have to thank him for his explanation and exposition of a natural health care approach known as chiropractic, a practice and profession that I enjoy myself. I hope you've enjoyed this evening's show, and it's been a pleasure speaking with someone with whom I can just about totally agree. Thank you very much, Dr. Dolan, and as always, this is Dr. Dolan bidding you all good health naturally.